Hey guys, welcome back. Today I am doing my 36-week pregnancy update. Holy cow, you guys. I'm gonna be 37 weeks in just a couple days, and I was just gonna film this either before or after my prenatal appointment for my 36 weeks, but it turns out I was running really late that morning and then I needed to get home right afterwards, so I really didn't have any time to do it. So I figured I would just sit down and share it with you guys today and just kind of have a dedicated time to sit down and talk about 36 weeks. You guys, it is so exciting to be at this point. I don't know if I ever really felt this way in my other pregnancies. If you guys are not familiar, this is my fifth baby, our fifth baby, my husband and mine's. And this was a surprise. And I feel like reaching this point, I'm like a little proud of myself. And it's funny because that's not normally a feeling that I experience very often. And I'm kind of just sitting in this feeling right now of almost like accomplishment. Like, I've reached 36 weeks. I'll be 37 weeks in 2 days. Oh my gosh, I'll be 37 weeks. And I think it's just because pregnancy is such a hard thing. And I don't even want to say it's hard for me. It's hard for everyone. And everyone experiences it differently, right? I was so afraid when I first found out that I was pregnant with this baby. I just had so many different emotions and thoughts, and I've shared that with you guys. Just with an unplanned pregnancy, I've never had that before. And so to be seriously surprised, thrown off, my plans thwarted, you know, and God basically intervening and saying, you guys are gonna have another baby, ready or not, this is my plan for you. It was a lot to take in. And this whole pregnancy has just been a roller coaster. And it's kind of been a process of me continuing to just have to give things over to God. And so to reach 36 weeks and know that I made it through all the sickness, I made it through all of the emotions and the insanity and the hot summer that we had, all of the things that I kind of was thinking about ahead of time and was really afraid of, to look back at it and know that I made it through really feels really good. And I'm not saying like I made it through because I'm the best. I'm saying like I made it through because God obviously gave me strength to pull through it. But I guess I just had this feeling of like, you know, I thought that it was gonna be this huge thing, and it was really hard at times, and it still is. But the reality of it is here we are, and I'm right around the corner from being able to meet this baby boy, and our family and our life will never be the same. And so that's really exciting. So that's kind of where my mindset is at right now. I'm kind of just trying to continually focus on the excitement of it and looking forward. And so it really is a good place to be, especially right before we enter into those last weeks where I'm, you know, every twinge, every feeling, is it labor? Or if I reach the point where I've gotta, you know, try to induce labor naturally, all of that. Like, the next 3 to 4 weeks are going to be a little crazy, you know, like a lot's gonna change in the next 3 to 4 weeks, and that's really exciting. So as far as symptoms go, I have still been having restless leg every single night. You guys, if I'm being honest, I dread trying to go to sleep because it is so hard. My legs are just, it's just the most uncomfortable feeling. I'm constantly feeling like I have to stretch them. It's one of those feelings that I think could just drive you insane because it just doesn't go away. And then I wake up multiple times a night to go to the bathroom, and then I get up in the morning and I feel like I was up partying all night, and I wasn't. I was just rolling from side to side in my bed, you know? So that's kind of where I'm at right now as far as sleep goes with this pregnancy. It's a battle. It's a battle every night. Another symptom that I have been having is lightning crotch. Okay, has anybody heard of this symptom before? Sorry for any of you that were not expecting that, but I have been having it. And a lot of times people can say, oh, you're gonna go into labor, it's right around the corner. But every single one of my last pregnancies lasted longer than the one before it. So call me pessimistic, call me a realist, I don't know. I'm not thinking that labor is right around the corner. I just think that when I am really active, if I'm walking around a lot and then I go to sit down, I can definitely feel some pressure, some like electrifying shocks going straight down my cervix. I can definitely feel those things. I do feel like he has dropped some. I don't know if he's going to fully drop until I go into labor. I do have a big amount of space between my chest and where my uterus is at. So I've noticed a difference where he's not so high. You guys probably can't tell because I'm still gasping for air as I'm talking to you guys. But I have noticed a difference that he is lower. And I've noticed just the pressure in my pelvis. For a few days, I was having a ton of pain on the sides of my uterus above my pelvis. And it was round ligament pain. It was just my ligaments and just, it hurt so bad. I would walk and then I'd have to stop because the pain was just, I would say it was just very, very uncomfortable. Very uncomfortable. If you guys have ever had gas pains, then it's kind of like that feeling, but I had it on both sides underneath my uterus above my pelvic bone. I had that for a few days and then I ended up getting out my exercise ball and trying to just see if I could get him to drop a little lower, if maybe that would take some of the pressure off of the sides of my uterus above my pelvic bone. I thought maybe it would just take some pressure off, and it actually did. The more that I got on my exercise ball and just kind of like swayed my hips and bounced and tried to just adjust him, I do feel like he went a little lower in my pelvis, and it definitely got rid of some of that pain that I was having while he was a little, while he was floating a little higher, and it was just putting pressure everywhere. At my 36-week appointment, she did confirm that he was head down. She could tell that he was head down anyways when she took his heartbeat and she felt him. She knew he was head down, but she did do a real quick scan just to confirm that he was, and he was head down. I'm pretty sure he was facing down like he should be, because when she did the scan, I could see just the back of his head in all its glory. He had a really strong heartbeat between 125 and 130. Speaking of my last appointment, I met with one of the midwives and I absolutely love her. She reminds me a lot of the midwife that I had deliver Ingrid. And if you guys did not get a chance to see or aren't familiar with that birth video that I did for her where I talked about her birth, I was so happy to have the midwife that we had for her. I wanted her for my other births and she just wasn't on call those times. And so for Ingrid, she was, and it just like, it just came together so beautifully. And so she actually doesn't work at the birth center anymore that I'm going through, so I was a little bit bummed because all of the midwives are new this time. And so I was hoping I'd connect with someone, and I did. One of the midwives, specifically Andrea, I just love. I feel like she just is so down to earth, and she gets me, and she's laid back, and we're kind of just have the same mindset on things. So that has been really encouraging. So my 36-week appointment, we discussed a few things that I was feeling apprehensive about, and I just walked out of there with more of a clear mind and just felt a lot more at ease. I don't know if she will be there when I deliver. In a perfect world, I feel like it would be wonderful if she was, but I know that it doesn't always work out that way. And I didn't have my choice midwife in my other births, and they were still really amazing. So I'm just trusting God that whoever he has on call, whenever baby Abe arrives, is the one that is supposed to be on call. This birth will just be John and I. Because of the COVID-19 restrictions, there is a limited number of people that you can have. So you can have a doula and you can have your support person. I really wish that I could have some kind of photographer there at this birth. I had my cousin, who is a photographer, do both of my boys' births, and neither one of my girls' births were photographed, and that wasn't intentional. That's just kind of the way that it came to be. But I do know how hard it is to get those good pictures when the only person taking the photos is also your support person and is there with you, you know? So I'm just kind of like trusting, and I'm just giving that over. I'm hoping that John will be able to take some good photos, at least of me birthing and of his delivery and birth, but we'll have to see. I have beautiful memories even from the births that I didn't have photographs of, but I would really love to have just a couple good shots, just for my memory and for Abraham, just so that he has those. So over the last month or so, I haven't really gained very much weight. And I was wondering if this would happen. I gained a lot of weight, I feel like, in the very beginning and as I was growing, and now I can't eat that much food because I don't have that much room in my stomach, and I just have not gained very much weight. So for a total weight gain of this pregnancy, I think I've gained around 40 pounds, which is equivalent to what I gained in every other pregnancy. In every one of my pregnancies, I've gained about 40 pounds. So I think that just is my body's comfy spot. We will see though. I am not due for another 3 weeks. I'm almost 37 weeks, so for another 3 weeks, so we'll see. I never underestimate my ability to eat some tacos and to put on some weight, so we'll have to see. But overall, I've gained about 40 pounds, which for me, I'm fine with. I feel comfortable with that. He's gonna be born before I know it, and then I'll be postpartum and the holidays and all those things, so I'm not even thinking about any of that kind of stuff until 2021. As far as like nesting goes, I have a huge list on my phone of things that I want to get done before he gets here. And so that's been kind of nice because I've just kind of been going through my list and checking things off. It's been helping me to keep my mind off of that feeling, you know, that you get at the very end where you're just anxious and you're ready for the baby to be born and just to meet your baby and be done being pregnant, you know? So I'm trying just to focus on the things that I need to get done. I reorganized our kitchen a couple days ago and I need to finish doing the other half of that. I did go through like the kids' fall clothing, and I always think I have more than what I do. And then much to my dismay, I pull out all their stuff and I realize we do need to get some stuff. So we actually don't need to get that much for the boys. They have a ton of jeans and pants. We have been blessed to have people pass stuff down to us for the boys. But Ingrid had nothing at all. And then Fiona definitely needs stuff. So I've been checking things off of my list and feeling good about that. It feels nice to be accomplishing things. And other than that, I've just been kind of nesting and preparing for him to get here. I can't really say anything super negative about how I'm feeling right now because I know that so many women just experience extreme pain or complications and things like that at this stage or even before. And right now I feel pretty good, and I'm really thankful for it, especially this being our last baby. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this update. It feels so surreal to be on here and be doing a 36-week update for our fifth baby. Feels crazy saying our fifth baby still. We're just praying over the next few weeks. If you would pray with me and for baby Abraham that he'd have a safe delivery, I do plan on continuing to do updates for you guys. So I hope that you enjoy them. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, please comment down below. I'm planning to do a pregnancy Q&A, so I would love to answer any questions that you have. I hope that you guys are doing well, and I'll see you guys in the next one.